I went to Charlottesville to attend the Unite the Right free speech event, and to support the Nationalist Front organization. People would have a better idea who was attending the event if our speakers were allowed to speak. There were people on the right side of the political spectrum, anywhere from run-of-the-mill constitutionalists to far right, southern and white identitarians. So there were many people of many different views there, not just quote unquote white nationalists and Nazis. And as far as the whole Nazi and white nationalist and white supremacist terms go, I feel like those are racial pejoratives, clearly to stifle discourse. I've stated in different publications that I'm a pro-white activist. We feel this is the beginning of a new civil rights era, and this time it's going to be a pro-white one. As far as the term white supremacist goes, in my view, anybody that thinks white people don't need advocacy, they're the white supremacists. I don't really want to speak too much about my family and their harassment, but we are still investigating this hashtag #YouYouAreRacist organization that is threatening not just me, but many members or many attendees of the rally all over the country. They threaten my 13-year-old niece. You know, as far as what brought me down this path, you know, I've always wanted the truth on everything, and it's just become more and more apparent that to advocate for pro-white interests is one of the many things that people on the opposite side of the political spectrum are trying to claim is politically incorrect. In my view, it's factually correct, though.